इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस, इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस रेफर्स टू द मूवमेंट ऑफ चार्ज पार्टिकल्स थ्रू एन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट व्हेन सब्जेक्टेड टू एन इलेक्ट्रिकल फील्ड। पॉजिटिवली चार्ज पार्टिकल्स दैट इज कैटायंस मूव टू कैथोड एंड निगेटिवली चार्ज पार्टिकल्स दैट इज अनायंस टू एनोड। सिंस proteins exist as charged particles, this method is widely used for the separation of proteins in biological fluid. This technique was invented by Arne Tiselius in 1948. There are few factors which affect electrophoresis. The rate of migration of the proteins, that is separation, depends on following factors during electrophoresis. First, net charge on the protein particles, that is PI of protein. Second, mass and shape of the particles. Third, the pH of the medium. Fourth, strength of the electric field. Fifth, properties of the supporting medium. And the last, sixth, temperature. Electrophoretic apparatus. This apparatus basically consists of the electrophoresis tank. It holds the buffer and is fitted with the electrodes. It also needs a power pack to supply electricity at constant current and voltage. When electrophoresis is carried out, the buffer is chosen in such a way as to ensure effective separation of the mixture of the protein. For example, serum proteins, which are separated at a pH of 8.6 using Barbiton buffer. At pH 8.6, all serum proteins have a net negative charge and will migrate towards the anode. Second, the first factor affecting the electrophoresis, that is net charge on the protein particles. The fifth, which I told you, the properties of the supporting medium. The properties of the supporting medium affects the electrophoretic activity and its efficiency. And the supporting medium are of different types. The supporting medium for electrophoresis, the first is filter paper. With filter paper as support medium, electrophoresis is carried out for 16 to 18 hours at a low voltage. That means the whole process needs 16 to 18 hours. This long time interval and diffusion of particles leads to blurring of margins of the separated protein band. This is disadvantage of paper electrophoresis. The second is cellulose acetate membrane. It is preferred as solid support media for horizontal electrophoresis. Cellulose acetate strips are used. It is expensive, but process takes less than 1 hour. there is excellent separation without diffusion. This cellulose acetate strip is widely used for separation and identification of lipoproteins, isoenzymes, and hemoglobin. The next type of medium is agar or agarose. Agar or agarose are heterogeneous polysaccharides and less expensive than the cellulose acetate membrane. These are viscous liquids when hot and solidify to a gel on cooling. That means at room temperature it is solid form. The gel is prepared in buffer and spread over the microscopic slides and allowed to cool. A small sample, that is few microliters of this sample, plasma, serum, whatever may be, or biological fluids, is applied by cutting into the gel with a sharp edge. It needs only 90 minutes to run the electrophoresis and we get the separation. This technique may be modified by introducing the antigen-antibody reaction, that is known as antigen-antibody reaction resulting into the immunoelectrophoresis. So when we add this antigen-antibody reaction to the simple electrophoresis, it becomes immunoelectrophoresis. This method is used to separate different types of protein mixtures. For serum proteins, it is commonly used, as well as for nucleic acid mixture. The next type of the supporting media is polyacrylamide gel, which is known as polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. In short, it is known as PAGE, PEG. Polyacrylamide gel has a high molecular sieving effect. So separation is very efficient. In agar gel, we get 5 fractions of the protein, while in polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, serum shows more than 20 different bands. Amount of cross-linking and thereby the pore size can be controlled as you need. Another common useful variant of this PAGE is SDS-PAGE. SDS means sodium dodecyl sulfate. In this process, protein is boiled for 1 to 2 minutes with a denaturing agent, and that denaturing agent is SDS. The negative charges of SDS cover the protein molecule, making them strongly negative. Now the separation of protein molecules will depend on mainly as their molecular size. So this SDS PEG is commonly used for molecular weight determination as well as for assessing the purity of proteins. Now, after separation of the protein, how will you visualize the band? It is not, cannot be seen by the eye unless until you dye it.